did.
You want to drive wrong?
Very little cold, straight up.
Thinking he's going to hit the 4 foot.
We'll try that. All right.
It becomes interesting because there are now two Ontario Stones in the ring and just one Saskatchewan Stone, and the Ontario Stones are positioned so they're not easy to remove.
Okay, so Brian, yeah. That's a shot.
Yeah. Randy feels he's got to go after it.
Couldn't move much. Straight.
Yeah.
You heard Brian say, do you want to just draw to it? He said, no, we've got to go at it. Let's go get it. You can only see about half of the stone.
I think that's a shot, eh?
If they do hit and roll out even, Ontario would have to play the raise or a draw, and they would only be able to get one, it looks like. So as long as he hits this out.
What's that? Well, I think I want to throw the one over here. As long as they get it out.
There's what he's looking at.
The second stone for the Saskatchewan skip, Randy Wojtowicz.
Yep.
Looking at with this raise is it looks like the second Ontario Stone, the shooter, would be outside the rings if he noses it straight on.
He really doesn't have anything else, so Linda. He's got to run this back if he can.
All right. It's a hair more than board.
I think you're right, Linda. There's a good look at it. If he hits that right on the nose, the shooter will
I nosed it last. I almost nosed it.
I guess if we cross it.
We were here, right? Yes.
Oh no. What, actual legs?
No, okay.
Yeah, okay, I know what you mean. Yes.
Mine didn't run to zero. They pulled a bit
at the end. Now you had hacked. We had almost draw away.
Yeah.
Right? There?
Yeah. Firm board. Try to nose it.
Yeah. Tight out here, right? Tight out here.
Down here. Meaning it's a little heavier out there.
Firm board, a little more than I had. And we'll try to nose it. We might be in for two.
He's hoping.
Might need a little bit of an inside roll. He could still stay for two with that bit of a roll, but it'd be tight. It's over curling.
It's gone. I think he threw it inside, though, Linda, because they yelled right away.
It'll be a steal of one for Saskatchewan here in the third end. Randy from Regina leads Russ from Penetang.
This is Jay. Jay doesn't say much when he's enjoying his McCain Super Fries. And he doesn't seem to care that Super Fries are cholesterol-free and low in saturated fats. McCain Super Fries, deep-fried flavor and crispness from your oven. For the strong, silent type.
The 1992 Labatt Briar comes to Regina's Agridome March 8th to the 15th. For tickets and information, dial 1-800-667-1992. And we'll see you back in the heartland.
For all the driving hazards winter may throw your way, we introduce the new full-time four-wheel drive Subaru Legacy. Because you can't control the conditions you drive in, we make sure you can control the car. The Subaru Legacy is renowned for its legendary full-time four-wheel drive. So when the weather goes to the dogs, your Subaru comes to the rescue.
Don't miss the great action on Canadian sport fishing each week on TSN, the sports network.
Update for you, Quebec against the Territories. They're playing the third, 2-0 Yukon and the Territories after stealing two. Kevin Adams gets on the board, makes the hit and stick for one. It's 2-1 as they go to four. Northern Ontario. Ontario, Nova Scotia. 2-0 for Northern Ontario and Rick Lang. Final stone, Dan Bentley of the Halifax Club. Bentley makes the hit for his two. Another stone, you see it peeking through there about 2 o'clock, biting the red. So 2 for Nova Scotia. Newfoundland and British Columbia. It's 1-0 for Newfoundland as they play the third final stone for Jerry Kent of Cranbrook. The red stone biting the back of the button. He's got to be right on top. No more. It's a steal of 1 for Newfoundland. They lead 2-0 going to 4. And finally, PEI against Alberta. 1-0 for Robert Campbell of Charlottetown as they play the third final stone. Kevin Martin, the Avenir Club. Gets through. Oh my, kills them both. Put a deuce on the board for Martin and Edmonton. 2-0. You will not miss a thing right here. The Labatt Briar Tank. That's what we're playing for all this week here at Cops Coliseum in Hamilton.
Well, a big steal for Randy Wojtowicz from Regina, Vic. And in this end, he threw his first one. He asked John Gunning to draw the first one to the top of the 8 foot, and that's exactly where he got it. Russ ignored it and threw up the corner guard. John hit that corner guard and rolled over the other side with his first one. Russ ignored it again, threw up another corner guard, and we just saw that corner guard run off. Wayne Madar.
I thought about putting up another corner guard, but they do have one up there, and they've decided to play the freeze. The thought is if they can get it close to the red rock, maybe there'll be a miss hit. And they can draw in behind the corner to sit two.
It'll fly. Hurry!
They want to glue this.
Beautiful.
Very nice.
For those people that don't do a lot of curling or aren't involved competitively in the game, you know, we're trying to point out the various ways, Vic, of generating offense. Now, Russ Howard is down 2 points to a very, very good team, and his options were to throw up another corner guard, like Linda mentioned, or to go around that corner guard that they already have up there, or to freeze to the face of the stone that sits in the 8 foot, and that's what he chose. Now, this all of a sudden becomes a very difficult shot to get out of the rings.
Well, you just have to think back to the game that Wojtowicz played against Nova Scotia when Dan Bentley made a similar kind of shot. Wojtowicz, with his last stone, couldn't remove the Nova Scotia stone and allowed Nova Scotia to tie the game.
Whoa. Oh, very lucky on that one.
Eight of the last 11 Labatt Briar champions have gone on to win the world championship. Can you name them?
Ray's nodding his head. I'm not so sure I can.
Hard. Real hard.
Would take the whole program.
Hurry. Hurry. Wow.
Hurry.
Hard. 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 Wait. Hard. Hurry. Hurry. Hard.
Well, a little bit of luck for Saskatchewan there. Looked like a flash by Wyatt Buck for a moment. Just ticked it over, and now Wayne Madaw gets a good hit and a good roll.
You want to run it? No, I think we just come this way. Go bomber.
Okay.
Brian McCusker wanted to run the guard back, and Randy said, no, we'll come into it. He happened to catch the guard okay, but we can see half of it.
Two-year-old Brian McCusker, the Saskatchewan third.
You don't want to miss everything.
Whoa. You sure didn't want to do that. That's exactly what you didn't want to do. No one knows it better than Brian.
Yeah, I know.
But what it does is it just chips the rock over, and now there's an opportunity to come around that corner guard. Look how far it chips the yellow one over. That means they can come around the corner guard, Ontario can, and the rocks will still be a little bit separated because that one's just biting the edge of the 12 foot.
Yeah, it gives Russ a good chance here to get his deuce back. Brother Glenn. That's a lot of ice, he says in the hack.
He's just a little nod of the head. Very subtle.
I'll decide, Russ says.
You're still my little brother.
Now, the fact that he can come around this guard, they're actually looking for a possible three this end because two rocks would be behind guards.
Rather than be in the open, they'd rather come up short here, Linda. He's not going to get the move. They'd rather be short.
I bring it back so there's no double takeout or a good hit and roll.
Hurry!
That's a tough one because there is the double now. At least a hit and roll behind the guard.
I didn't think it would move that much.
How much you got this way, Brian?
Russ was, as you mentioned, was kind of going for three because the other option is to go to the wide open side and then wait for your shot and wait till you get down to maybe Russ Howard's first shot himself, then go in to try and get your three. Because if you go to the open side, Randy's going to hit it and try and exchange a couple of times.
Second stone from Ryan McCusker.
They don't like this one. It's outside a little bit again, I guess.
Wow.
Well, a chance for Glenn Howard to get the roll. This is what you're looking for down this area here. Hit this and try and roll the rock right over into this area here, right there. Kind of a funny little roll, wasn't it, Vic?
I don't know if they're putting these out a little wider if the spot here is very straight. They're running right down a line, just hitting them on the nose.
Yeah, very spot.
Won't go there, huh?
Eh?
Won't bend there.
No, it's only up to the first one.
There's a bit of movement there.
I know there is, that's what I mean. It comes a little bit. Let's go there.
Russ says it won't go there, and Randy says, yeah, there's a little bit of movement there, so you've got two different opinions. If there isn't movement there, if it won't go there, then you've got, I think, your best, Russ is best to go to the open side and take the deuce, you not let, not take the chance of setting up a double or the roll.
This bumper. Ryan was a little saucy, was he? Totally is, but he got him back.
For those of you that haven't been with us, we'll just mention once again that Randy Wojtowicz takes a lot of time lining up. He doesn't go down into a hack position. He starts from a trunk lift position. There it is there. Has an excellent flat swing right from the shoulder. Rocks well out in front. And a great clean release.
No.
He doesn't. He thinks it'll move a bit here, and Russ doesn't think it will. We're soon going to find out.
Well, look at this.
Beautiful shot.
Absolutely.
That one moved, I'll tell you.
Well, he said Brian McCusker had put it back. That means he put his hand and floated it towards center. If you let it go cleanly, Randy thought it would curl. It looks like he was right.
Mm-hmm. They jumped on it quickly because it must have made a big move, Linda. And just as they get to the stone, the call by Brian is to just to leave it and pick the double up right here. There it is. A good call by the third, Brian McCusker.
Randy Wojtowicz watched this one all the way down.
Little body English now, just to leaning in.
Let it roll a little bit, boys. Yeah.
Russ is going to play the hit. In turn, and the outside in.
Wait.
Looking for a roll, but
he's throwing those very nicely and softly. It just won't come up.
Yeah. Well, you know, let's just review the end quickly. I mean, obviously Glenn had a couple of chances either to, you know, Russ made a decision to make the try and get the roll in behind the corner to try and set up a possible three. I mean, the other option, Linda, as we talked about, was to go roll right to the other side, or even when they had the chance to draw there, they could have drawn to the far side and try and make sure they cinched their two.
Yeah.
36-year-old Randy Wojtowicz. The 1984 Canadian mixed champion. Brian McCusker, his third, played on that rink with him. And his final stone here in the fourth, leading 2-0 Ontario with last rock. Oh my. Peek out the other side very much?
Not very much, a little bit. Just about a perfect shot, Lindy. We could have, he just doesn't roll quite that far. He forces Russ to draw for a single, and that's the objective when you don't have last rock, is to hold your opposition to one. And it just rolls a little bit too far, so Russ can hit it and blank the end, but he has to be very careful in doing so. Cannot give up another steal, not against a great hitting team like this. Clean, keep it clean. Good call by Glenn.
So Ontario will maintain control of the hammer with a blank in end number four, but Saskatchewan is steering the lead 2-0 here in the sixth round.
It's winter. Let the games begin. When the games are through, it's time for a blue. Labatt's blue. It's the way we play.
Flying from the top of the key is easy. It's the landings that kill your feet. That's why I fly with the pump from Reebok. When I pump up, my size 13s get support, protection, and a custom fit. So, Michael, my man, if you want to fly first class, pump up and air out.
Switch to the greatest sports performance shoe in the world. The Reebok Pump. Pump up and air out. Wednesday, join the wave at Hamilton's Cops Coliseum as Canada's top skips vie for curling supremacy at the Labatt Briar. Host Rick Hodge takes you ice level for an in-depth look at the American Hockey League on ringside. Then, catch up on all the latest news and features from spring training and sports dance. We've got exciting Briar action ringside and the spring training news and sports dance Wednesday on TSN.
Update for you, Northern Ontario, Nova Scotia, as they play in a 2-2 tie. This will be the final stone for Rick Lang and his rink from the Fort Williams Club in Thunder Bay. Everybody comes out now to try and draw this one in. They see the yellow stone back 4 foot. That's the stone, so he's got to have full four. Come on, boys. Come on, fellas. From the north. Well, it was a draw for two. You see the yellow, rather red stone there. Didn't see that one. He could have had two if he had the right weight. He gets one. It's 3-2, Northern Ontario. Newfoundland, British Columbia. 2-0 Newfoundland as they play the fourth. And this is the final stone. Jerry Kent of Cranbrook has to hit and stick on that stone at the edge of the four. Flash on by. Another steal of one for Newfoundland. They lead 3-0 over BC. Nearing the midway point of this sixth round, 1991, Labatt Briar. The Territories continue to lead Quebec 2-1. We updated Newfoundland for you. Manitoba with two more, leading New Brunswick 4-2 as they go to 5. Northern Ontario, we showed you the one by Rick Lang, had a chance for two. They blanked 4. Alberta continues to lead PEI 2-1. And that's our game as we go to the fifth end with Saskatchewan leading 2-0 over the former Canadian and world champion, Russ Howard. Linda?
We've got lots of action again. There was a rock placed into the rings by Saskatchewan. Russ Howard put up a corner guard. Saskatchewan hit that corner guard and rolled over to the center. But Ontario's been able to get at the rock in the house and made a beautiful, quiet takeout. Saskatchewan's going after that rock in the rings. Lovely exchange of stones early in the end.
What has made the last couple ends so interesting, Vic, has been the fact that there's been a rock or two in front of the ring. So, you know, that's what makes it so interesting, you know, trying to get the rolls in behind and or the come arounds. And it's the front stones that really do make a difference to the game from an entertainment point of view. And you're talking about the best curlers in the world, and they can make all the shots. And we've seen an example of that here.
Linda, we've gotten some good response to our phone poll so far. Should a provincial champion be given an automatic entry to defend his title the following year's provincial championship? So far, 268 of you have said yes, 162 no. We'd still like to hear from you throughout the rest of this sixth round of the Labatt Briar. It'll cost you 50 cents. We'd like to hear from you. 720-6071 if you say yes, 720-6072 if you think it should stay the way it is. Interesting. People think that the majority of people right now think that the provincial champion should get a free ticket back.
To the provincials.
To the provincials.
Yeah, and I think it's a good idea. That's my opinion. Okay. What's the number? I'll make a call.
Give me your 50 cents.
That's right. Here's 50 cents.
Thank you very much.
Would you tell them in the truck that they can add one to...
They say not until you give them the 50 cents and send it down to the truck. They're not going to put it up.
I thought that Russ might do this, and Ontario's decided to ignore the Saskatchewan rock at the side of the 12 foot and try and come in. I think it was going for the hit because it is hard to bury these, but it will finish at the end if it's perfect weight.
You bet it's a good shot, and you're right. And that, you know, that it wanted to. It was one of those stones that was trying to finish. It just wouldn't go, but it makes it difficult to hit now. You can only see three quarters of it.
He wants hack.
Don't overthrow it, is what he said.
No.
To Brian McCusker.
Well, off.
Okay. Off. Line's real good. Clean it.
Clean.
Clean. Just clean. Attaboy, B.
There's some nice movement in there.
Well, that's beautiful control of weight. That's why Saskatchewan's 4-1 and also number one statistically. They're just playing that weight so beautifully.
Glenn Howard, the 28-year-old, is the manager of an Ontario Brewers retail store in Orillia, Ontario.
Clean. Hard.
Stephen Leacock, Gordy Lightfoot, Ray Turnbull.
Yeah, you're right up there.
Oh, yeah.
I think they have a couple of monuments of broken brooms there. That's just the club, yeah.
I never curled there, though. I did live there in Orillia for 10 years, though.
Well, you were on right on the lake on Kuchiching, were you?
Well, I went there, went to the park many times. We lived up in the town.
Legendary stories. If you're familiar with the area, the Pav in Orillia.
My father retired in Washego, actually, and had a home there. Rolled a little too much, Linda.
Brian McCusker's second stone as we play in number five. Saskatchewan leading 2-0.
He doesn't have a lot of weight, but it looks like it's running very straight.
Just enough to dock it out.
Yeah.
Russ must have thrown that attempted double inside then, because that was a good indication of exactly how straight it does run.
A little light.
Just a little light.
Having a giggle about it.
Just a little light.
Because you're flipping things and stuff. And that one I didn't know. That one I got down, huh?
Getting them down.
No, I know. I was trying to get it down.
I just think, don't do anything. Just come out and just let them go like you always do. I just think you're coming out just a little soft and you're trying to be too...
Boy, they're keyed for this, and they really are pumped.
Sure, you know,
they're noticing, and Randy's saying, look, at you coming out, a little too much adrenaline, a little rush of blood. Let's just play the game.
Let's talk about the carrot at the end of this particular event. That worked a bit too, didn't it? They must be throwing those.
We get in a little tighter.
Well, there's the explanation. You get in a little tighter, it moves a bit.
We'll go here in a little bit. The throwing right.
Rotation. That looks tight to me.
I don't think so, Brian.
Yeah, okay. It'll wait a while.
That was an interesting conversation that Brian and Randy were having, because what happens in these games, especially the ones where you feel you're playing a team that's at the top of their game and you know you have to come out and have the perfect weight, is you start to play a little bit because you want to extend out with that hand and throw it just so. And then you start to overthink.
Mm-hmm.
And Randy said, just come out like you always do and let go of the rock. Don't play with it.
I'll even half a hit and flops or threes or something stupid like that. Hey? I think it'll vary here, guys, but you got to throw it pretty damn good.
You're darn right you do.
It's naughty. What do we get, three, maybe? Just give me this to Hammer.
Now, probably the reason he's not playing the other turn is if he didn't quite get in there, even if he did come in half buried, there was a hit and a roll to his side rock, so he's trying to spread his rocks out.
A little tight.
Line's okay.
Line's good. Lots of room.
And he did, the other reason, he thinks it'll finish for him.
Lots of room.
He thinks once you get over a bit, it'll finish.
Yep. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Looks like great line. Maybe just a little too much weight.
Russ Howard in the third end, barking out the call as he always does.
That's where
looking to play the straight back raise.
That's right. That's where he was trying to raise there, and it moved. So I think he must have. That's the one we just referred to. He must have thrown that inside pick.
And that was the steal of one after Saskatchewan had gotten one with last rock, and that's why it's 2-0. Saskatchewan leading. Russ Howard in his Ontario rink as we play the fifth end, and this is the first stone for Russ Howard, and he does have last rock advantage.
He's gone to the intern here, Vic. He's going to play the intern around the guard, try and get to the face of the stone, sitting on the just behind the button. He thinks this will it'll make the move. It depends on the weight.
Well, Randy's rock is about a foot deeper than he wanted, because this rock can come up to it on the edge of the button.
Boy, if it curls, all it has to do is curl a little. I mean, all the little things are just not working for the Ontario team. And Saskatchewan is playing fabulous, so. But those are the little things that make the difference. If that curls, watch this, Vic. If that just makes a little move now, right about here, and he can angle onto it, it becomes a very, very difficult shot for Randy to remove, and he'd have to come down to it and kind of concede 1 point. But it's now open.
I thought that rock would bend more.
Oh, I see. That did quite a bit. I think it would edge before you were about the first.
No, it's hitting. We're in real trouble. Inside roll, we're in worse trouble.
Yeah, you're right.
We always get that little bump, eh?
Just the little things.
Yeah.
Had to be there, though.
Yeah, I didn't want to guard it.
Perfect.
We talked about this being a big game for Russ Howard, but it's also a very big game for Randy. It really, you know, puts him in a great position.
He was telling his sweepers about half weight, he thought.
Well, clean.
The final stone for Saskatchewan here in the fifth.
Clean.
Ooh, he's got it going.
Kick. Come on.
No inside roll, but it's beauty just the same.
It's a great shot.
Inside roll may have been a bonus to him there.
Well, you heard Russ say, if he hits it on the nose, we're in trouble. He's
throwing against three. I mean, you forget about that one at the 12 foot sitting there.
Well, if I was throwing, I wouldn't be forgetting about it. That's right. One of the problems.
If he hits it just off the nose, with even quiet wake, he should be able to tap them back.
Yeah, that's what I
mean. Or hit it a little thicker and roll farther. Like what? Like you thinking board?
I'm thinking board. You should hit it thinner than it looks, don't you?
Yeah, normal might be easier.
Yeah, it might be.
Because then we just get any piece of this, and I'm going to stay here.
Yeah, I like that better.
I do too.
Just deciding the weight, Vic.
Yeah. That's good.
Board weight. This is a big shot.
He's down normal.
Got to get his single.
Down normal.
Glenn's making sure that the rocks will roll. There's no debris in the house.
Where? Yeah. When you roll up on the edge of the eight, Wayne.
The final stone for Ontario and Russ Howard. He trails 2-0. And trying to bail himself out of trouble here.
Can't hit it on the nose. He's going to catch it a touch on the outside.
No. He'll drive it by. It curled just a little too much. And it's another steal of one for Saskatchewan in the fifth. Randy Wojtowicz and his Saskatchewan rink from the Tartan Curling Club in Regina. Now lead 3-0.
The acclaimed PBS series on the Civil War is now available on home video cassette from Time Life Video. The reviews are overwhelming. If better use has ever been made of television, I have not seen it. A video miracle. Magnificent. 5 years in the making, the Civil War brings to light the most devastating conflict in our nation's history. It's the lonesome dove of documentaries. It's the complete story of the war as told through the eyes of those who lived it. Call now, and we'll deliver your first episode for just $19.95 plus shipping and handling. Watch as a massive Union army meets Robert E. Lee and his rebels at Gettysburg to wage this legendary battle. The Civil War. Call now. Use your credit card and call toll-free for your first episode on the Battle of Gettysburg for just $19.95 plus shipping and handling. Future videos will arrive about every other month. There's no commitment to buy. Cancel anytime. Fact is, we're number one. Why not call us first?
With White Swan serviettes, it's always a happy ending.
While most of the nation's in deep freeze, TSN brings you a taste of summer. Whet your appetite for some good time cruising with the Powerboat television show. We've got the latest in what's new in the water, what to buy, and how to get the most from your Powerboat. So if it's a leisurely cruise you're after, or open throttle, high speed excitement, turn to TSN for the first word in water sport for the family. Join us weekly for the Powerboat television show, right here on TSN. Sports Update is brought to you by Kellogg's Corn Flakes. Taste them again for the first time.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the TSN Control Center. I'm Gino Reddle. We'll send you back to Cops Coliseum in Hamilton momentarily. Right now, I can tell you some NHL news, a truckload of trades in the NHL. Far too many to talk about right now. We'll discuss that 11 Eastern on Sports Desk. Right now, let's take a look at some scores. The St. Louis Blues in the first period lead the Hartford Whalers 1-0, thanks to Brett Hull's 71st goal of the season. The Blues hold a one-point lead over the Blackhawks in the Norris Division lead. Pittsburgh leads Vancouver by a score of 1-0. They're also in the first period of play. Kevin Stevens with his 25th goal of the season. Penguins winless in their last five games. The LA Kings lead the Washington Capitals 2-0. They're also in the first. Granato and Buskas have scored for LA. And one more score to tell you about. Toronto leads Boston 2-1. They're in the first period of play. I can tell you that after five ends of play, Saskatchewan leads Ontario 3-0. And right after this, we'll go back to there.
The trouble with Honey Nut Corn Flakes is they're just too good to miss.
People will do just about anything for that light taste of honey and real nuts. Sprinkled on crunchy flakes of corn. Kellogg's Honey Nut Corn Flakes. The trouble is, they taste too good.
The Labatt Breyer Tankard, and the winner will have the name engraved on the championship trophy stand. A reminder to stay with us right after the game here in the sixth round for the TSN Turning Point. Brought to you by National Trust. New Brunswick as they play the fifth, and Manitoba leading 4-2. Final stone for Grant Odishaw, skipping this Gary Mitchell rink from the Beaver Club in Moncton. He's the hit and stick for a pair. Right on the forefoot, little inside roll as well. So they are tied. It is 4-4 as they go to six. Newfoundland and British Columbia. Newfoundland leading 3-0. Got one, stole one and three, another one and four. And right here, British Columbia's Jerry Kent from Cranbrook has got to draw at least full 8 foot. Got to have full 8 foot, Jerry. But he'll come up just a little short. And John Boland of Gander will steal one more in five. And now leading 4-0. Prince Edward Island and Alberta. As they play the fifth, 2-1 Alberta. And the final stone for Robert Campbell and his rink from Charlottetown. Can he pick that stone off the button? Like a surgeon. And it is 3-2. Now let's get you caught up. All the games now. In fact, they're picking up and moving right along. And there you see the game. It's Yukon Northwest Territories ahead of Quebec 4-3. We updated the game for you. Newfoundland leading BC. All steals except for 1 point. 4-4, you saw this. Northern Ontario. Nova Scotia came back with 1-5 to tie. Rick Lang, 3-3. That's our feature game. It's been a tough night for Russ Howard so far. Some great curling by Randy Wojtowicz. And PEI with two in the fifth, playing tough against Alberta. Let's remember, Robert Campbell from Charlottetown dropped his first three, has won two in a row, played giant killer beating Ontario, and he might beat one of the leaders here tonight in Kevin Martin of Edmonton.
Well, you really have to give a lot of credit to the Saskatchewan team, Vic. They've just played sensational. Russ Howard has had his chances. He just hasn't got the little things that make the difference in a game sometimes. But Randy Wojtowicz has just executed everything perfectly. And that's the reason for a 3-0 lead.
Coming into this draw, Ontario had had three and stolen against them. Well, you can add two more to that number tonight. Things just not going quite Russ's way.
Well, we no explanation needed with that. It was a hog rock. Randy threw that first stone, John Gundy's first stone, into the rings. He wanted it in front of the forefoot. It ended up behind the forefoot. And a hog rock gives him the opportunity now to come down to the top of it.
10 points between the second. Thinking back. Didn't they, Ontario hog one earlier, or was that Saskatchewan?
No, that was Ontario.
That was Ontario. Mm-hmm.
Second stones early in the game.
Yeah, and then was that the one they decided was a bad rock, they thought, and maybe gave it to Peter the lead?
It's very possible.
That's the lead's job. Right, Ray?
That's right.
Take this bad rock.
Right, Ray?
Yeah, skips are good at that. I had trouble, though. I used to run through 8 rocks, and I never found one I liked sometimes.
That's right. You know, sometimes if you know, my skip would miss a couple shots in the game, I would, you know, really, I would just take that stone and say, Terry, it's not that rock is not acting the way it should act, and even if you don't feel that, sometimes from a psychological point of view, it can be, you know, work.
Well, better that you throw it in a maybe less crucial situation than he did.
And what I'm referring to, even if I didn't feel that there's anything wrong with the rock, just for a psychological change, you know, just to. You know, it's such a tremendous team game. You have to work all the little things to make the champions.
Of course, there is another possibility for a hard rock at this point. Have you ever heard of the signal? There have been cases where people have purposely hog rocks or done something to force the other team into bringing more rocks into play. Yeah. For example, if they'd thrown up a corner, Saskatchewan would have peeled it off. Now they have two rocks in the forefoot because they hogged that rock and Saskatchewan played into the rings.
Right.
It has been done.
Oh, sure. Many times. I don't think in this case, though, Linda.
No, I don't either.
It's a chance, though. You're right. Randy came into the rings with his second shot, and so now if Russ can get down and just tap that back, he can put his stone in front of two rocks.
The Ontario second, Wayne Madaw, as we play this sixth end with Saskatchewan leading 3-0.
Real hard.
Certainly not the numbers you would expect from people of the quality of Brian McCuster and Glenn Howard.
I'd run it off. You heard Brian say, let's guard it. I agree with Randy. I'd run it off there. He's got a 3-0 lead. He's got complete control of this game. And if you don't throw up the guard, probably they run it back.
I like the guard.
You like the guard?
I'm wondering if we should try to go around it on an intern.
Nah.
I don't like that.
I like the guard.
I like
so
the hit.
If you come
right
on, try to come around and don't puff them in, then you're certainly looking at a bad situation.
No, I like the guard there. Now.
Just a guard, right on center.
You got to make sure you cover that. Cover that yellow stone. And Russ Howard's in deep trouble here, and so he needs rocks in play. And I know you're down to the thirds, you know, Brian McCuster's stone, but Randy's first gut feeling was to run it off, Linda. He walked up to run it off, and he's changed his mind, so we'll see what happens here. Yes, you can lock it up and maybe score a couple, but sometimes these stones can work against you.
He leaves the rays, I think. It's hard to tell. It looks like the rock, the Yellowstone, may just be open.
Is it there? It's just there, isn't it?
I guess so. Split won't kill us either.
That's right.
Mind you, I don't know how we're going to get out of these if you split it.
Back four. Well, back four.
Back four.
See, this is terrific example of them being, you know, two shots ahead. And this is what the game is all about. This is what, you know, why we call it a game of chess, because you are playing one and two shots ahead. He said, if you get the split and roll them both in the rings, that's not too bad.
That's plenty.
And then he throws up the guard, and we can always come off our own. Playing the raise.
Glenn Howard.
Lot of room. Clean. Wow.
I got it.
That's a good shot. Yes, sirree.
And he bumps it enough, and Ontario is shot stone 4 foot at 3 o'clock.
And what rock do you think is causing the problem?
Really?
Yep. There's a guard on that stone, and
lead,
it's
really.
belonging to Saskatchewan.
Here's another look at it. You see that red stone? That was the rock that was just thrown up. Boy, if that curls even another little inch, it is. It's a good shot. It's a great shot anyway, but now it's the red stone up in front, the rock that Randy put there that's causing the problem.
Comes back to haunt him.
I think so.
They're just going to tap it back. They can see it. They can see, I would think, just by lining it up with the center line, I think you can see a good full, maybe three quarters of it. Linda, what do you think?
Looks like you can see a lot of it. What they don't want to do is have it hang a little bit and rub off it and leave some opening for them to come in. It has to be in front.
Yeah, I don't mind that stuff.
They're talking about guarding it, but I think they can't guard every possibility for Ontario to get
actually,
in.
Even if I'm short of it, it's not bad. I'm just going to try to throw a tee line.
He's playing it quietly. He's going to try and tap this one right back into this area here. That's about all. But even if he does that, you know, Linda, Russ has still got the raise again, and it's a little more open now than it was with the last one.
He's got lots of weight. It's just for line.
Ooh.
Real good drive, E.
You see, you know what I'm going to say.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to say it.
The guard was maybe questionable.
You go right back to the guard that Randy was going to run off. He's got a 3-0 lead. He was going to run that baby out of there, and now all of a sudden this has turned around. Because it deuce puts this a whole new light on this game.
They're right back into it.
We came around top.
Try and listen to them.
Yeah, I like that. I like that. You can weld it too.
Meaning you could freeze it.
Go here.
Come around top of the 4 foot.
Terrio still has three stones.
Shot, but it's not dead.
Yeah.
Ontario line one.
Yeah, I won't even dare. I don't want this. It's got to be higher than that one.
A chance. They see a chance and they can make a good shot here.
Tight.
He's tight, he said. He was inside.
Glenn Howard, second stone here in the sixth end. 3-0 Saskatchewan leading.
Looks like it's got lots of room. They wanted to be top 4 foot.
Wow, a lot of weight. Wow, leave it high. Hard! Hurry, hard!
Was there a little indecision there?
That would have been.
Whether to bring it back or to leave it high as Russ.
Well, they wanted the top 4 foot. It just wouldn't curl, you know? I think it's a pretty good shot, though, because you can't hit that shot rock on the proper side. So he's got to go after the top one. Now, the only thing is, if he gets the top one right, he can make the double, Vic. This stone to bend a little bit. You take this stone and put it right in this position here, then this double that he's going to try, like so, would not be there. Hitting that one, one will go that way, one will go that way.
What do you think of the numbers here? 85 for Whitewich, Howard 65.
Tells a story, doesn't it?
He has to be a little careful with this one. He doesn't want to drive it back on his own.
No. It's got a little more weight.
It's not going to come up. They're going to go for it the other way.
By doing so, they remove the second shot at the back of the four, but Saskatchewan's second shot, edge of the eight and wide open.
Good call, Brian.
Yeah, it was a good call by Brian. Here's another look at it. He almost hit it as, like Linda suggested, if that curls a little bit more, he's going to hit it back on the other end, and Ontario's going to be left lying two.
That's not bad. It doesn't hurt us to get the those rocks that are moving. So both are 6 at best.
Especially this rock's brutal. So I'll be like, I'll be five.
You want to throw it last?
Five.
You want to throw it last? So I think that rock's a little slower. I think that's what they're referring to, Linda.
Yeah, a little surprised he's kept it.
Oh. He's just throwing it a hair better.
What Russ is saying is, if he just had thrown it a little bit better and curled a little bit more, he would have driven it right back onto the back one. It's a pretty nice number, isn't it, Pick? That's your annual salary.
That rock will die.
Yeah, thank you very much.
That rock will die.
I want you to come negotiate next time.
Really got a ball.
The little rub wouldn't be too bad. Looking for the little chip.
Hurry.
Gee, that's not what he wanted, Linda.
Just through there, because that one of yours pulled up pretty good at the end.
Yeah. You know, you come back to what you said before about the little things that not going right. You know, you might normally see Russ make shots like this, and you know, it's just not going for him.
Well, Russ couldn't have made the double easier. I mean, it's absolutely a simple. You know, in hindsight, I guess they should have pounded it all away and tried to get the little chip middle roll, but they're looking at the angle of the stone coming off.
It looks like it would come over the top of the red rock the way the two yellow stones are lined up.
I thought I might have too.
My God, I've heard that.
You heard Glenn say to Russell, you want to throw it last, throw the other stone, and throw the other one last. So, but it all started with not taking off the guard. And that's the last time I'm going to say it.
He may be on the guard.
Randy Wojtowicz, will he open the door for Ontario here?
Oh, yes.
Oh, boy, look at this. And now, isn't that something? How quickly one shot will turn around and end, huh?
He knew he threw it inside. He let it go inside. They yelled right away, and he's sick about it, obviously. But chance for Russ to pick up 3 points, and we're going to have a tied game here.
Full eight is what the Ontario skip needs here in end number six.
Boy, they hammered this right away. Keep it clean. No mistake this time, and
so Ontario and Russ Howard will take advantage of that opening. If Randy Wojtowicz had only kept it clean, he may be still leading.
What's the secret of McCain's richer tasting juice? More oranges. McCain concentrates the juice of more oranges into every can. More than Minute Maid, more than Old South. So you have a special reason to buy McCain.
You bet I do.
It's like an extra squeeze of juice in every glass. So compared to Minute Maid and Old South, you have an extra reason to drink McCain.
You bet I do.
Wake up to McCain.
For all the driving hazards winter may throw your way, we introduce the new full-time four-wheel drive Subaru Legacy. Because you can't control the conditions you drive in, we make sure you can control the car. The Subaru Legacy is renowned for its legendary full-time four-wheel drive. So when the weather goes to the dogs, your Subaru comes to the rescue.
March is the month of champions, when universities from across Canada send their best to the CIAU finals. Get behind your team as the finest volleyball, basketball, and hockey teams in this country make the grade. TSN's got a winner. Be watching March 9th and 10th as the top women's volleyball and basketball teams are decided at the 1991 CIAU Championships. Live coverage begins Saturday, 10 p.m. Eastern, only on TSN.
Update for you, Northern Ontario and Nova Scotia as they play the sixth. And it is a 3-3 tie. Final stone, Rick Lang, Fort William, Thunder Bay makes the hit and stick gets the little roll across the top of the 8 foot. Picks up his 1 point and leads Nova Scotia and Dan Bentley of Halifax 4-3. The Territories ahead of Quebec 5-3. That's after seven. Newfoundland still in control, leading BC 4-0. Manitoba, New Brunswick still locked in a 4-4 tie. We just updated the Northern Ontario score for you. PEI Alberta, it's 3-3. They're playing seventh. And in our game, dramatically and suddenly, Ontario and Saskatchewan 3-3 as we go to the seventh. We're at Cops Coliseum. And it's the sixth round of the 1991 Labatt Briar. And this is the Saskatchewan lead. This is John Grundy. And yeah, you think back, Linda, that's what came back. That's what, if anything turned around the game, may not be the shot itself to get the 3 points, but in fact, the guard that was left up there.
Well, both Ray and I questioned a little bit, but Russ made some great shots. He's made another one here. Peter Corner made a beautiful come around and came to the face of the Saskatchewan Rock at the back of the house. This one looks like maybe a little bit heavy.
Okay. Live update for you, Manitoba, New Brunswick. 4-4 tie, final stone. Jeff Stoughton trying to kill them both. He'll leave one at the back of the four. A steal of one for New Brunswick. And they'll lead at 5-4 after seven. And it is now Grant Odishaw skipping that rink of Gary Mitchell from Moncton.
Could come around by Peter.
Sort of the reverse situation we were talking earlier. If you have a bad end, maybe it's time to regroup. And now Saskatchewan looking at a big comeback by Ontario. Maybe looking a little bit tentative. That one was heavy. They've got to calm it back down. They've been playing very well.
They didn't want to leave it this high. This allows Randy to go around to the top of the forefoot. And there's lots of movement there.
Yeah.
Let's try and hear.
It's not a bad call.
Huh? You want to peel?
I think so.
Yeah. I think maybe we'll peel this one.
Saskatchewan second, this is Wyatt Buck.
Look at this here. A little bonus. Ooh. I thought he had more weight on it, was going to clip it out, Linda, but he drove it back onto the nose.
It caught the second guard a little bit thick and pushed it straight back.
Sorry, I was a little light with that one.
It's actually not a bad shot. The main concern was the guards. They've spread the rocks in the house around a little bit.
I thought for a minute he might just catch the edge of that yellow one and split them both out. Momentum. You know, it's interesting that momentum is a very big part of this game as well. And just, they talk about it in football, they talk about it in hockey, they talk about it in all the other sports. And momentum is a big part of this game. All of a sudden, it's kind of just switched a little bit. Look at guard.
Decision there, Linda. What was their thought?
They were looking at peeling off the guard versus coming down to shot stone, and they decided on the little tap back or even drawing to the face of the rock in the forefoot.
Hurry! Hurry! Hurry!
didn't it?
Okay, here's why. Why? It's a good shot.
This is what we wanted to know in the sixth round of this Labatt-Briar. Eight of the last 11 Labatt-Briar champions have gone on to win the world championship. Can you name them? Well, how about four tonight and four tomorrow?
I don't think we have time for me to name them all.
Here we go. Ed Wernick with two, Al Hackner with two, Rick Folk, Ed Lukowicz, Russ Howard, and Pat Ryan. The Ontario third, Glenn Howard. His first stone as we play the seventh, and now a 3-3 tie.
Good. Great. High. Three. High.
Right up.
Clean. Clean.
Clean.
Yeah.
I don't think you'll have any voice by Wednesday. Wednesday night. Little tighter. Good guard.
Saskatchewan would love to get one in there and at least make Ontario go after the rock so they can't keep putting up these guards.
They want this to move a little bit, as Linda mentioned. Just get it. They got a good line on it. They can get it there.
Light.
Oh dear.
Guard part of the red one?
Yeah. Okay. What do you think?
Yeah,
I got
like
another
that.
One.
I like that.
Right here?
It's going to guard the red stone out in front.
I think so. I think we can't really afford to leave. Well, we could leave that red one. Throw it tighter.
They don't want to leave this shot right here, so they're going to play the raise out in this area here. Nibble the line, he said. Nibble the line.
Glenn Howard and his second stone. Wayne. Saskatchewan Wayne. Now has last rock. For the first time in the game since the first end, Saskatchewan has last rock.
Clean it.
It's not curling much.
Let it die.
Yep.
You just need to nibble the line.
That's good positioning. This is a mess for Saskatchewan.
No, I gotta move something.
Well, it's exactly what he asked for, Linda.
Line, maybe. There's a half rock on that one.
Yeah.
We half rocket. We can either come off this and drive this in, or we might even be able to drive that straight through. Okay?
You think I can half off this, you mean?
I can half rock this way.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I can half rocket, yep. Attach this and move it in.
Yeah.
Or we can either, if we miss it, it'll drive it straight through.
Well, the best is to hit it onto red, huh?
Well, what we're gonna try to do is play the half rock this way. And then if I miss it,
then we'll get it that way.
Okay? Turn away to you, so peel. Okay.
Well, there's a couple things that can happen. You heard Randy explain them. And the big thing also, they can get some rocks off the front unit. That's kind of the reason that they're playing this. And he said, if you miss, you're going to drive the yellow one onto the red one and hope that it pushes it through. If not, you'll run the yellow one straight back and you get the rock off the forefoot. But you can also get some rocks out of that front.
Well, we have quite the game going here in the sixth round of this Labatt-Briar from Cox Coliseum. We're glad that you're with us, Vic Roeder, along with Linda Moore and Ray Turnbull. Saskatchewan and Ontario in a 3-3 tie. And this is Saskatchewan's Brian McCusker.
Yes! Vic Waite, you heard him talk. Peel Waite.
Hooray!
Looking for half of this stone, Vic.
Hooray!
One. No.
Tries it through.
Much of an opening.
Might be okay with hearing.
It's not going to be any faster.
They were trying to hit it much thinner, way on the outside, and this is almost a nose hit, just a little bit off nose.
Wow.
Brian McCusker watched it all the way down.
So it's tightening up down the center, but I don't know if it'll be tightening up out here. No,
and then saw it. He knew he had driven it by.
5.5. No, it's not getting any faster, but we're out tighter. We're wider.
Now, they get this rock covered perfectly, then Randy's really in trouble. He's going to have to try again to get something off the front. Just laid it down.
Just over.
Clean.
They don't want it to overcurl. Clean. That's why they've stopped sweeping.
Good.
A little bit of an opening here. You can see a little bit of that back rock.
Should be an inside block there.
Curled a little more than he thought. Either that or he threw it inside. I think he must have put it inside a bit. We'll try and listen to Russ and Glenn when they move behind the house.
Kind of dirt in the bed, and you just kept going.
It shouldn't go out that wide. It shouldn't move at all.
Well, you got to move it that time. It's a dead weight, I guess.
Well, we were really worried we could float it there.
Yeah. I think
you make the double now.
Yeah, I can.
I think, as Glenn said, you got it going. In other words, you got it started over. There's what they're talking about.
Yeah, they think there is a double there.
Yeah, if he hits that on the outside, he can get the double.
Okay.
And if Russ puts that card up properly, boy, they're really in trouble.
Remember the hack waiter he threw?
There's the possible
the
double.
He threw? Didn't bend an inch.
There is two. Hack weight, eh? What, hack weight?
They're having another look at it. They're just making sure that, I think the first prerequisite is to make sure that their rock stays.
What he has to do down here is he's talked about playing it with a little more weight at first, hitting it on the outside and driving it across here, making a double here, the other one going this way. He's now changed his mind. He's going to play with hack weight, going to play a little quieter.
The difference in the game is that three that came in the sixth end for Ontario. Up until then, it had been all Saskatchewan, but as we say, love this game. Dramatically, it turned around.
Interestingly enough, Linda, there's a spot, they think there's a spot out there that will really run straight, and we saw it run straight down there earlier, but...
Can he get two? He wants one, certainly. This, and he didn't push it just enough. Ontario remains shot now, nibbling the back of the eight.
He's got to be careful where he places the stone, though, because there's those two little red rocks in there.
But the great thing about that is he got that rock off the 4 foot. He was looking at nothing for a while there. Now that rock is only back 8 foot, 12 foot. So if nothing else, he's going to have at least a draw for one.
Or top eight.
You leave it wide open.
He almost made the double that he wanted, Linda.
Where were we?
Had the roll just a little bit more. You threw it. Had to come a little more, I should say.
Let's go here, and I'll be top 12 or short.
Why do you want to come in that deep?
Well, because he's going to draw the 8 foot.
If you leave it there, we're in trouble. We're going to give it to him, that's all. Unless you want to, if we can half tuck it, great, but...
Russ Howard is thinking about it.
Yeah, shorts may be safer.
Well, Russ wanted to come into the 8 foot like so, and you heard then say, why bring it that tight? We'll leave him the double. And then he said, well, if you could come around like so, that would be terrific. But, boy, you better not leave it in the open. Glenn said, let's play it up here.
What do we want to do? Do we want to go in?
In like so. Put the guard up.
Yeah.
Remember, Saskatchewan does have last stone.
Top 12.
Top 12. You got to get this up or you'll give away the three again, Linda.
Yeah, you've got to at least block this side.
Right up. Clean.
that's what Glenn wanted. Glenn said, don't come in too deep, Ross, otherwise you'll give him the double this way. So what if he has to draw to the 8 foot?
Should stay straight. Yeah, that's going through that draw last and fifth end. Huh?
If Russ had made his first card, then they had things going well for them, as Linda suggested.
I'm sure Randy's quite happy that he's walking down the ice only facing a rock in the back 12.
One. What are we looking at? Have I thrown one this game?
Have I thrown a draw this game?
Where did I put my draw? Oh, yeah, behind the button, eh?
That's right.
Even that ball. I got that out to the broom.
It's not as quick as this afternoon.
An impulse. Yeah. I guess we had the right ice the first time.
Yeah.
On the first one.
And I turned the first one over there.
You turned it in, that's right.
That was a great.
Good crowd tonight.
The final stone of this seventh end of play. Saskatchewan, Randy Wojtowicz needs full 8 foot with this draw.
Just wait.
In a 3-3 tie with Russ Howard of Ontario.
Fight the eight.
Wojtowicz from the Tartan Club in Regina makes the pressure draw. It's a big game for these two rinks here in the sixth round of the Labatt Pride.
Mr. Freud is analyzing dreams.
Not analyzing, but my book talks about dreams like yours.
Ben Randall, referring to Mysteries of the Unknown, the Time Life series that sold over 14 million books.
Dreams and dreaming.
Uh-huh.
You of all people think dreams mean something?
Well, I may be coming around a little.
Well, what do you think my dream means?
It's right here. A dream that you're being chased could mean a feeling of guilt and a fear of being caught.
Guilt?
Mm-hmm.
What else could it mean?
Read the book. Ever had a dream come true?
Never. Who has?
Sarah Allgood. In a dream, a friend said, have you found my gift from the grave? Look behind the picture. So Sarah looked, and there it was. Turned out to be worth over $1,000, too.
There what was?
Well, read the book.
Call and order now. Read Dreams and Dreaming free for 10 days. Keep it and pay just $16.99. Other volumes will follow, one about every other month, including Mystic Places, Psychic Powers, and Phantom Encounters. Keep only those books you want. Cancel anytime.
Oh, I don't know if I can get back to sleep now. You know what? Some of that pie, maybe a la mode might help.
Okay. You get the pie and I'll read the book.
Read the book, huh?
I'm running out of steam.
Update for you, Newfoundland, British Columbia playing the seventh. And it's 4-0 for Newfoundland. It's the final stone. Jerry Kent Cranbrook gets something going here with the hit and stick for two, and so he's on the board against Boland of Gander. Northern Ontario, Nova Scotia. And it's 4-3 for Rick Lang, final stone for the Nova Scotia rink. And Dan Bentley out of Halifax. Two Northern Ontario stones, top four, back four. Doesn't want to jam it. Plays it through. He'll give up a steal of two. It's 6-3. Let's get you coming up now. Nearing the end of this sixth round of Labatt Pride, Territories continue to lead Quebec. Newfoundland 4-3 after eight. New Brunswick has moved in front of Manitoba. You showed you that steal by the Moncton rink. Northern Ontario stole two to take a 3-point lead over Nova Scotia. PEI continues to play tough against Alberta. And in our game, Saskatchewan with one in the seventh, leading 4-3 over Russ Howard as we go to the eighth end of play in the sixth round of the Labatt Pride from Copps Coliseum.
Well, that was a fun end, you know. There's a lot of rocks in play. If Russ Howard gets that the guard on, that would have made Randy's draw very, very difficult. I don't know if he could have got right to the forefoot for the one. He certainly could have cut him down to one, but Randy made a terrific draw. You know, I mean, he went down to the ice, Linda, and he said to the guys when he sat in the hack, you know, when was my last draw? You know, can you remember what it was? Oh, yeah, I put it behind the button.
Wow.
That's what the game is all about, the ability to be able to remember, to go back and repeat. Throwing up another corner.
Hurry, guys, hurry! Come on, way back, way back. Nice dream.
Off the corner.
You were talking about momentum. It's almost like a little weight has come off the shoulders of the Saskatchewan.
Yeah.
They look confident again. Look like they're throwing those appeals very well.
Rick Lang and Northern Ontario are a winner in the sixth round, 9-3 over Nova Scotia.
Which one?
So Rick Lang and his rink from the Fort Williams in Thunder Bay now 4-2, Nova Scotia. Dan Bentley, 1-5. 9-3, the final.
Was that Rick Lang or Mick Jagger?
Yeah, it's true.
Hard! Hard! Hard for line! Hard!
They were trying the freeze, but it looks like this will overcurl.
Leave it short. Hard!
That makes for kind of an interesting call for Randy. you could just see him.
Do you think he remembers the six? Deja vu.
Yeah. Here's good.
Tap it. Okay. If we tap it, that's okay too.
If we tap it, it's okay, he says.
Just the way. Guys, we got lots of rope.
Easy.
Yep. Okay, easy. Oh, no. Okay.
Sets up the double.
Really nice weight, Brian. Good shot.
You can actually maybe get the double in a little roll, Linda.
Pretty firm.
Normal, yeah. Nah. Normal, fine.
We do both. Make a double roll at the same time. This one's trying to move up this line. Okay.
You heard what Glenn said. We can get the double. Hits that there. That'll go that way. That's out that way. And we can get the little roll right in there. They want the roll behind the guard.
That was almost like it caught something. They were staying away from the sweeping. Glenn was saying stay with it, but at the very end, it looked like it either overcurled or caught something. Watch it break off the line.
Check.
Just suddenly broke.
Plus it's flat.
It's not, it just had to move with 2 inches. I was quite happy with it. Hardly any weight left.
Play that one.
I get it.
But Glenn thinks he threw it harder than it turned out to be, Linda. That's kind of what he's saying. And he wondered why the guys weren't sweeping it. Randy's not going to leave that stone in play.
Lee, Saskatchewan third, Brian McCusker.
No!
Let's play, Mike.
Well, there's an example. You could hear them say, thank goodness he didn't overthrow it. He got a little outside the broom, but that beautiful weight, it would have a chance to come up, catch the corner, and roll over.
Four on top. We almost have to go this way.
Didn't really curl to the very end. Just a corner of the Yellowstone. And actually, he rolled to a great position because he rolled behind the other stone. So now they can't hit the shot rock and roll in front of second shot. They have to go after second shot.
We're here. Some more people can come watch our club games. See?
Maybe a few more.
Thanks.
And a nice compliment from Russ Howard as well to Brian for the fine shot.
That's what Russ thinks. I don't. Yeah.
And a great comment from Randy Wojtowicz. A few more people come to watch us. Not many more people come to watch us for our club games, do they? Yeah.
Wow!
You're right in the big one now, boy. This is the show.
Wow! Oh. Back! Oh. Wow! Wow! Back! Wow!
Look at this. Look at this. Did he get a little wick off that yellow stone to straighten it up?
No. They actually had to brush it a little more, I think. Oh, if they were.
Didn't know what to do with it.
No, I didn't know. He should brush it to roll it over in front of, or you know, or leave it. I mean, leave it to roll over in front of, or brush it so he get the roll behind the guard. Wasn't sure.
I'll have a crack at it anyway.
Yeah. That's how you get those purple hearts.
It's getting so wide, isn't it?
Yeah, wide. Okay, more hack weight, I guess, eh?
The rock is open, so Randy's going to play that nice hack weight, try and tap it out and maybe roll over.
This just sat there for a while and then come at the end. No, I don't think so. They all seem to sit there. You like that ice? Or?
I was thinking of taking less. Little less.
He's referring back to Glenn Howard's take out the curled so fast at the end.
The first stone for the Saskatchewan Skip, Randy Wojtowicz playing end number 8 and leading 4-3. Oh my, what a lovely shot. Yeah, sounds like that'll make you smile.
Makes you a little nervous. You take a little less ice and then maybe a little bit inside the room, and the sweepers had to work on it to get it by that guard.
Well, there.
Leave it in.
Got it by the guard, Randy? Did you get it by the guard? Come on, fellas, pound those brushes. You get it by the guard? Boy, just what a shot.
Well, it's decision time. He could come down and freeze to the face of it. And
they
could play the hit and maybe
freeze. I like to freeze. Okay.
Look for the blank, Linda. They like to freeze. They
go this much? Go this much?
What do you think, Lou? Would you maybe try and get play the hit and get the roll to the open side, and or play the quiet hit and try to get the roll behind, or play the freeze?
I kind of like playing down to it, maybe tapping it a few inches. Maybe you'll get a miss hit. As long as the rocks are grouped, you should be okay.
This rock's a little slower, Petey.
He's still playing with that stone, which may not be one of the best.
Some thought is that you could, you could maybe try and get through the end and get into the next end with the hammer a little bit.
Where is it? Hurry, hard! Hurry, hard! Hurry!
Gotta go!
Hurry!
Gotta go! Gotta go!
Hurry! Hurry!
What do I know about this game?
Great shot.
I guess the difference is I never make those.
Yeah, I bet you far.
Oh, yeah. Great shot, though.
It's a good shot. It just curled a little too much, is what he's saying, but it's still a great shot.
We always leave him a shot.
That's right.
It's 2 inches that side. He has to guard.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's another inch that way. He guards for one. Good shot, I like.
He never leaves it.
No, shouting in their ear, but they certainly worked hard on that one.
Shouting now, whispering by the end of the week.
Because he's like, I can move it and get Shot Rock, get first and second out of it. No, I would just play something soft, eh? That's not bad either. I don't know. Let me take a look again.
They're talking about the options, whether to hit, try to hit. And we talked about earlier, Rock that's almost frozen is hard to remove.
Well, the other thing we can do is just draw. If we draw right to it, he's going to have a hard time getting two. We can put it right there.
Well, if I can go right here.
Yeah, but if you go right there, then he can hit a nose. This one's going nowhere, and he can still get two.
We better pick it.
But you could play that, Randy.
No,
then he's got to draw the button.
Let's pick it.
Okay.
They're going to try and pick it. He talked about playing.
Get in there, right? He can double us both out and sit there for two anyways, right?
They talked about coming down here like so and just touching it back a little bit in line two, but you heard him say, but then he can doubles out for two. So what they decided to do is come down with pretty good weight, hit this, try and pick it this way, go this way. They're going to try and pick this.
I don't like the tap. I'd either play the draw or the hit. We just need a corner of this rock.
Ontario with last rock here in the eighth.
Attaboy.
There's the pick. That's what he played all the way.
Now Russ Howard with his final stone. We'll just try to get the hit and roll the shooter out.
The only reason the pick was a little easier than the one we talked about earlier today is the rocks were slightly staggered. One was almost beside, a little bit beside the other, a little bit of separation, and so the angle of it was better than the one where this afternoon they were dead frozen.
Actually, from the 12 foot in, once he got across the center line, he just went nuts. Yeah.
Russ's freeze just came a little bit too, curled a little too much and left that angle into.
Final stone of this 8th inning.
They want to blank this.
And they will. Boy, an interesting end of curling. That one went back and forth. Both teams having their chances. It remains 4-3 Saskatchewan. When we come back, the 9th end, 6th round. Love that prior.
From the Wild West to the mean streets, Clint Eastwood has enforced his own style of law. Now you can own his greatest movies with the Clint Eastwood collection from Time Life Video. As a gritty cop or gunslinging renegade, Clint delivers non-stop action and some of the most famous one-liners in screen history.
Go ahead. Make my day.
Start your collection with the outlaw Josie Wales for just $4.99 plus shipping and handling. Part philosopher.
Diane ain't much of a living boy.
Part sharpshooter. Josie goes out for revenge.
And you gotta get mean. I mean plum mad dog mean.
Other videos include Hang 'em High, plus Dirty Harry, and Magnum Force. There's no commitment or minimum number to buy, and you keep only the videos you want. So call now for the outlaw Josie Wales. Here's how to order.
To order your Clint Eastwood video cassette, call 1-800-354-3800. That's 1-800-354-3800. Or send just $4.99 plus $4 shipping and handling to Clint Eastwood Collection, P.O. Box 600, Station R, Toronto, Ontario.
It's winter. Let the games begin. When the games are through, it's time for a blue. Labatt's blue. It's the way we play.
Update, Prince Edward Island and Alberta as they play the 8th. Then it's 4-3, PEI leading, final stone for Kevin Martin, the Avenir in Edmonton. Hit and stick for two. You bet, Alberta takes a 5-4 lead over the island. Here the other
other scores late now in the sixth round of the Labatt Prior. Yukon Territories still leading Quebec 6-4 as they play 10. And the Territories will have last rock at 6-3. Newfoundland ahead of BC. The rink from Cranbrook has last stone there. Manitoba, New Brunswick in a 5-5 tie. In New Brunswick, the rink from Moncton does have the last stone there. Northern Ontario already a winner, 9-3 over Nova Scotia. Rick Wang, the win tonight. Saskatchewan, Ontario, that's our feature game as we go to the ninth end. 4-3, Saskatchewan leading, and Russ Howard and his rink from Penetanguishene, Ontario, do have last rock advantage.
Well, you know, if you like this game at all, no matter where you are in this country, you're being treated to, in my opinion, tremendous entertainment. Vic, it's, you know, we've had a little bit of everything, lots to talk about, lots to telestrate, and don't turn off your set because it isn't over. Lots to come.
It's run the full range of emotion, missed shots, making shots. The momentum has gone back and forth between the two rinks. As we go to this ninth end of play.
Right off. You ready?
If you're not enjoying this game, then you really don't like curling.
You think of the number of freeze attempts they've tried. Now, they've come very close to virtually every one. That one is a little off angle, but the weight was perfect, and that's quite incredible.
Because it is the toughest shot, Vic, in the game.
I've heard that, Rick. Here are the final results of our phone poll on this Tuesday. Should a provincial champion be given an automatic entry to defend his title in the following year's provincial championship? Yes, according to you, and we thank you for participating.
Hard. Light.
It was only 3:15 until my vote.
Hard. Hurry, hard.
There's quite a difference there.
You think they'll guard at this end?
I don't think so. Little thought.
That's incredible.
Should I go for it now? Hit it. Peel, he says.
Third stones in this ninth end, and this will be the fourth or the first for Glenn Howard. This toughest shot in curling looked pretty easy.
I just can't believe how many they've tried.
Great judgment too. And
it's a great way to counter the peel game that we've seen played so well by Saskatchewan, but you've got to make them.
This can be squeezed, but you have to hit it properly. You have to catch it on the outside. You can't hit it on the nose. You certainly can't hit it on the inside. Push, he says, push. He got it. Whew, almost curled too much.
Brian McCusker cleans house.
Glenn is saying is let's throw it in the rings and go for it in 10, but Russ says no, let's put up the corner.
What Glenn's afraid of is if they throw up the corner, then he just might go around it and try and force Russ to take the single. I think maybe he should go down the ice, Glenn.
Yeah, still not sure. I think I'm going to go a little
tighter. If we go through the side, we can get a couple of overhand. If we go real wide, it's just a couple of overhand.
Go right here.
Short.
Yeah, but over farther.
There?
Over farther.
Yeah. Why?
Hey?
Well, they're going to throw it up.
What's the what was the concern about where that guard is, whether it be wide to over 12 foot or over 8 foot?
Well, Russ wanted it over a little further, covering the 8 foot, but Glenn wanted it a little bit over towards the edge of the four.
Any reason, Linda?
Well, I thought the reasoning was that if the other team, Saskatchewan, drew to the other side of the rings, it wouldn't be as far to try and roll behind the corner on the opposite side of the sheet. That was the only explanation I thought he was talking about.
And you can see now, this is what Glenn was afraid of, is that he might try to go in behind it and force Russ to take the single.
Chance of getting a force this way, which is a little safer.
The force, talking about the force.
Yeah, I like that too.
It's a good call to try and force Russ to take one, but you got to make it, Linda. If you don't make it, you can give up the deuce, and that would be the control point.
And don't make it means it could be exposed, it could be too deep. There's lots of ways that it could go wrong.
I put it in the top ring, top 12, half buried.
Randy White, which concerned somewhat about the time remaining. Each team gets 75 minutes to play, and he is now under, and Saskatchewan and are now under 12 minutes.
Good line.
Line's nice. Just a wait. Top ring.
Line's great.
Top ring.
Still room.
Cross it. Yeah!
Hurry.
Hurry!
Whoa.
Even by giving it a rub, it still finished at the end, huh?
Did you think it rubbed?
Yeah, I think it rubbed it on the way by and still finished.
Good judge.
I'm not sure it did.
I don't think it did either, Vic.
Okay.
But you have better eyes than I. So.
I don't know. Maybe I'm seeing rubs that aren't there.
We'll take a look at it.
See the angle freezes the bump.
Oh, yeah.
There, it's frozen now. Great shot of it. Let it go and see.
Yeah, right there.
I don't think so, Vic.
No, I think I got mine.
Great shot of that, you know.
Between Quebec and the Yukon Territories is over on sheet A. We'll update the score for you in just a second. The Territories winning that one. Russ Howard is a first stone in this ninth end.
To try to come to the corner of the red stone or maybe even tap it back a little bit.
It was just light. He's been talking about having one stone that's slower than the other.
It was heavy out of my hand. That thing's a pig.
You should have thrown it away.
I don't know if that's enough, Randy. Like you had right there on the first one. You're going out of guard.
It's cool there. It's not going to curl real hard.
Yeah, I think you're right.
And there is the final score. The Yukon Territories winning 8-4. So Chuck Haynes of Whitehorse, his record now 3-3. Kevin Adams, Glenmore in Montreal is 1-5. And the game between Newfoundland and BC is also over, 6-3 final. So John Bolin of Gander is now 3-3, while a 4-2, pardon me, British Columbia is 3-3. Newfoundland playing very well, 4-2.
Yeah, The only place this one can't be is deep. As long as he's front 8 foot, then Russ will have to draw around it to the 4 foot.
Well, the corner guard did exactly what Randy wanted it to do. It forced Russ to draw for the single. And he's going to have to draw for the single.
In the sixth end, the final stone for Russ Howard after Randy Wojtowicz racked with his final stone on a centerline guard. There. He left Russ Howard in the Ontario rink with the open draw for three.
That's that same spot.
And
no,
that three
moving.
Gave Ontario the tie after six ends.
I'm into the fresh stuff.
Saskatchewan picked up one more in end at number seven. And as we play nine, it remains a 4-3 game.
Maybe not quite as confident with his draw weight because he feels his two rocks aren't quite the same. He even looked at looking at the Ray's takeout.
Well, he'd like to blank it, Linda. That's the reason he was looking at that. He'd love to blank the end, but that's a long shot to go through the port and try and blank the end. As far as I'm concerned, he's got to take a single and hope to steal. I mean, those things happen, and Randy made a decision to go in behind that corner guard. And they made a good shot, and this is what's forced Ontario to take the single.
Russ was saying he thought it might be a little heavier out here when he was talking to Glenn, but Randy threw out here, and it looked like it slid quite well.
Yeah, clean. Picking.
Needs a piece of the four.
Boy.
That is some movement.
I think it might have caught something as well.
Yeah.
Just picking a bit.
Well, we'll put one up for Ontario in the ninth end. And so when we come back, it's all tied 4-4, and Saskatchewan will have that all-important last run.
Could have been the whiskey. Might have been the gin. Tell me, me, oh, me, oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Irish Rovers.
She's my joy and my pride, and she's 20 meters wide, and I call aboard the ship the Bonny Lady. Johnny, get up on the fire, get up and give me your man a sip.
They delighted audiences worldwide with their musical tales, and now you can get the Irish Rovers' Greatest Hits, a silver anniversary collection.
What would you do if you married a soldier? What would you do with the butt of the gun?
And the heart is captivated by the flower of sweet romance.
No Irish Rover collection is complete without this international blockbuster hit.
You'll see green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpback camels and some chimpanzees.
The Irish Rover's Greatest Hits, 25 years of musical magic on two LPs or two cassettes, $14.99, one compact disc, $19.99. Here's how to order. To save COD charges, use your credit card and call toll-free 1-800-453-2900 or send check or money order for $14.99 for LPs or cassettes or $19.99 for one compact disc plus $4 shipping and handling to Irish Rovers, P.O. Box 600, Station R, Toronto, Ontario, M4G4E1. That's 1-800-453-2900.
We're in Hamilton, and we're playing for the 1991 Labatt-Brier Tankard. Everything else is in the books in the sixth round. All the scores are final except for the game we're featuring, Saskatchewan, Ontario. The Territories beat Quebec, Newfoundland over British Columbia. New Brunswick with a final stone hit the stick to beat Manitoba. Northern Ontario, Rick Lang wins. And Alberta really had to sweat it to get by PEI 6-4. In our game, it's 4-4 playing 10. Saskatchewan with last rock, and we already have a quick centerline guard, Linda.
Quick centerline guard because the first rock from Saskatchewan was a miss of appeal.
Wow.
Well, it's waste no time, huh, for Russ Howard. He's got a steal. So Peter Korner throws up the center line guard. The Saskatchewan lead, John Grundy, with his first stone, misses it, and Korner goes right behind.
Shot, John.
Well, the only problem with coming in this early is you have to guard them all, but he had no option. If you tried putting up a couple of guards, there would have been a chance for a double takeout on the guard. So they've brought the one in, and now they need a bunch of guards.
Wayne Madaw.
Clean.
It's like what?
Clean. Lot of room.
Well, this is when it the pressure slides back to the front end too,
Linda.
You know, you got them. They got the miss that they required, and
hurry hard.
Great shot.
Good looking shot.
On the nose.
23-year-old Wayne Madaw.
Yeah, we're
going
to go straight field,
Wayne. Okay. Now ignore the one in the house. Keep peeling off the guards.
Good shot
by Wyatt Buck.
Tighter.
I'm going right down to the wire with this one, Linda.
They're all sweeping it.
They don't want to hog this.
And maybe that's slow rock.
That's the third time Ontario has hogged a stone in this game.
Really, that's unusual. That's the second time, or the third time, as you mentioned, Vic, that we've had hog rocks. I don't know if it was that same rock or not, but. It makes a big difference to this end.
Now, some people may wonder why you would roll your rock all the way out of the rings, but you don't want anything in play because that'll only benefit Ontario.
And we've seen Ontario make some very nice freezes, so that's certainly a possibility for them. Now, Russ Howard heads down. He wants to have a little chat with his brother.
We get 8 minutes. Let's just slow it down a minute.
I agree.
Yeah, really. That rock's great, eh? Yeah, I know.
Yeah. I kind of like dirt.
Where do you want to go?
This one is twice as strong.
Why don't we get one over on this side?
Okay, over right here, middle four.
Yeah.
Yeah, Wayne doesn't feel very well, does he?
Okay.
Yeah, but I mean,
that rock.
The team all knows that he is throwing a rock that he's not very comfortable with, and it's a team effort.
Is that the guilty stone, number five? Sure looks like all the others, but when you throw it.
Yeah, it does look a lot like the other rock stick. It's kind of the bottom that matters.
That little timeout was interesting, Ray, because the main reason for doing it was trying to slow the pace of the game because Saskatchewan was peeling those rocks off nicely and had a real flow to this end, so they just slowed the pace down a little
bit. That's interesting. That's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Lots of time on the time clock.
Russ said as he went down the ice.
Yeah. The Saskatchewan third, Brian McCusker, as we play this 10th in, 4-4, Saskatchewan and Ontario, and Saskatchewan does have last rock. There you see the time remaining. It's 6:49 and counting down for Ontario to finish this end.
Whatever. Sure.
The intern this time. Try and move it around a little bit.
Easy.
Players are left.
Clean.
Ball.
Whoa.
Ball. Wow.
Easy.
Okay, off, guys.
Oh.
Gonna come to a stop.
Husker and his second stone playing 10.
Big weight, no problem.
Well, we know this outturn shot there. I like that. I didn't mind what you were thinking right here.
One thing they can do.
I like that.
Saskatchewan, a lot of the teams that we've seen, they can certainly peel those rocks, no problem at all.
Linda, you had said earlier that the tendency from statistics anyway is that Saskatchewan likes to play the outturn, was that, am I correct? Any
That's
way
right.
here that you could play a stone to somewhere in the rings that might force them to throw an inturn, or will they just throw outturns at any place you put it?
Yeah, when it's wide open, they can play outturns at any place. That's why the leads rocks, the lead on the Saskatchewan team, he's throwing almost all outturns, because you really can't force the lead with no rocks in play to play the other turn.
Get her deep, keep her alive, Wayne. Come on now, hard. Get her deep. Hard.
The only thing about the outturn on this side of the sheet is the shooter has to roll further, so maybe he did have that in mind, because it looks like Randy will play the intern hit.
Oh, he went intern. Was that not an outturn? Was that neat, so outturn?
I think the outside end, as Linda suggests, so the shooter doesn't have to roll so far.
Move a little.
Do you think he read the stats?
It sounded like they were talking about trying to force him for the out to play the intern, and they didn't think he would, even so.
Yeah, which isn't bad.
Yeah.
And he missed this morning.
Yeah. Like 4 weeks left.
The same.
Yeah.
Yeah. Clean. What? Get a good look at it, what?
Well, the final two stones in this 10th end of a 4-4 tie, Saskatchewan and Ontario. Russ Howard in danger here of losing his third straight game after opening with three wins in a row.
To look for the rollout here to try and force another extra end.
attorney's gone to here.
Yeah. And the benefit of this one is he has the longest distance to roll with playing the out turn.
Nice way to do it here, AY.
Asking his second Wyatt Buck about the weight. The opportunity now for Saskatchewan with their final stone to hit and stick for the win, and a 5-1 record after six rounds of this 91 Labatt Briar.
Quality video. Jump. World figure skating champion Kurt Browning for the first time on home video, including exclusive interviews, never before seen footage, and full-length world championship performances. Featuring the story of the quad, Kurt Browning's figure skating first. An inside look at the high-pressure world of championship figure skating through the eyes of Kurt Browning, world champion.
There are two kinds of people in the world, those who want to know.
Harvey, these Light Delight dinners give us their cholesterol and fat levels.
And those who don't.
Delicious.
To those who want to know.
It's right here on the front.
Light Delight puts it out front.
Where we can see them.
Mmm.
For those who don't want to know.
Mmm.
Light Delight simply tastes better than ever. McCain Light Delight. The information's on the outside. The taste is on the inside. Mm.
Why does one person excel above all others? Is it motivation? Raw talent? Desire? Is it personal satisfaction? Intelligence? Luck? There's no magic formula, and there's really no secret. But there is Soloflex. Because Soloflex is designed and engineered with one thing in mind, your body's needs. And we've created the finest, most complete, and simplest system to attain those needs. With Soloflex, the reward is yours. For a free brochure, call anytime.
We're at Cubs Coliseum in Hamilton for this 1991 Labatt Briar. You want to say all he had to do was hit and stick. But he couldn't. And Randy Wojtowicz will now get another chance in an extra end. And Ontario goes right back to the guards.
Now we'll go through the whole process again, Vic. Cubs had a miss in the 10th end, but couldn't capitalize. They got a hog rock. So Randy had a chance to keep it clean right down to his last stone. And looked like he released it well, because when he let it go, he said, you know, keep it clean, but it just never moved for him. And we saw the results.
The Ontario lead, Peter Korner, in his second stone. Extra end, tied 4-4.
Been a long day for Saskatchewan, their second extra end game of the day.
Yeah. interesting as we pan down the Ontario Rocks. It seems to be if number five was that bad stone, Ray, it looks like the Ontario rink may have gotten rid of it early.
Yeah, I think Peter threw it, and
wow. He's firing that thing.
That's like three. Like this one?
No, go the other way.
There really isn't necessary to say too much about the situation. Our viewers can follow it very simply. They're looking for Ontario, looking for a nose hit, and Saskatchewan looking to keep it as clean as possible.
Oh, John.
Skipper down there brushing.
That's
Linda.
Right. You know you're in trouble when the skip comes out.
We used to tell Terry, my skip, to stay back in the house. Don't embarrass yourself.
Ontario's put up four stones and Saskatchewan has removed them all. So the lead, John Grundy, and the second, Wyatt Buck of Saskatchewan, have done their jobs. Come to third stones now, and right now, as of now, in this extra end, Glenn Howard out curling Brian McCusker.
Wait, the bullet.
Just caught something, took a little spin.
Little chuckle by Glenn.
It's always a good idea after a rock looks like it caught something to go out and clean the path, make sure that the piece of debris didn't fall off the rock, and if it did, your rock would run over it and maybe go sideways.
His first stone, extra end, tied 4-4. Just part of the Saskatchewan delegation here.
Go wider.
Randy Whitey, which is brother Rick, is part of the Regina committee here.
How about there?
The 92 Labatt Briar will be in Regina.
Yeah, here. The here.
Where are you going? Hard.
Well, just over the line. Right over the line. He's just going to hit the high side, isn't he?
Okay, where do you like it?
Pretty well got to get in the center. So.
but you know what I mean. If you went over here and he threw out turn, he'd have to, he could roll center.
Well, want to go against a little wider edge of the four there. See if you're throwing that out turn. See if you're moving a bit.
Didn't throw too good last time. Anyway, turn it this time. I like that.
A little edge of the button.
Yeah. Normal.
They're going to the house with this one.
Yeah, on my side.
Linda, hoping that he might hit it and stick, and then they'll have something to come down and lay on. They tried the long guards through the whole end and through the 10th end and just couldn't get a nose hit, so they're going to bring this one right into the rings and the edge of the button. That was a final decision.
They've only had one nan stolen to date, but Saskatchewan wants to get out of this one without another steal.
Russ Howard and his first stone here in this extra end, tied 4-4.
Great. Gonna pull a little far.
Plate.
Three.
Hard.
Come on. Hurry.
Hard.
Hurry.
Hard.
Yep.
Three. Three.
Come on, guys.
Three.
Well, it looks like they might have just been playing the guard,
right? Yeah, I guess so. They talked about coming right in, and I think you're right, Linda. Either that or my ears are going too. It's my eyes and ears now.
They did say they wanted to play that side of the sheet to try and force him to play an out, or if he played the out turn, which he likes to play, then he would roll towards center and maybe the rock would stop at center. But it looks like he'll just go to the in turn. Shorter distance for the rock to roll.
He gets the out turn going. It's a pretty normal bend. I like that.
Yeah. The three spot and the caddy too. Right in the middle of the loop. Right, isn't it? Skip on there.
Yeah.
Get that at the teetery spot.
Yeah.
It's going to maybe take that pole like after.
She might get another roll out here or flashing it. Miles, Randy White, which of course hopes to hit the stick for the win.
Well, what they talked about is they feel in the spot on the right-hand side of the 8 foot, there's that edge. Outside at the edge of the 8 foot, it will hang straight. There is a spot that might curl a little bit. They're trying to put it on the edge of that spot. So if he gets it at all outside with his out turn, it will fall off and roll out.
Watch it.
He's got to get it into the 8 foot though, Linda, because we saw Randy this afternoon when the rock was in the 12 foot, just draw, and that's what he'll do here as well, probably, if they don't get it to the full 8 foot.
The final stone then for Russ Howard and Ontario in this extra end.
Hurry! Hurry! Hurry!
High! Hurry high!
To the rings.
No, all the huffing and puffing wasn't going to get that one there. Well, this was Randy White, which is shot in the last end. Here he needed a hit and stick for the win in the 10th end.
Okay.
But couldn't hold the shooter as it would spin out the back. Now with his final stone, he has to draw any piece of the rings.
And it looked like he needed sweeping. They just didn't want to get on it.
Oh, I was going to be in the beginning.
That's my better rock, though, Glenn.
Yeah, I know. He was throwing so heavy to get it here. You just got to fire it.
Randy Whitewich, Saskatchewan, for the win.
All right. of the Purex pillow thing. So never forget, your mission in life is to be soft. Much softer. That's better. Now, present softness.
Pillowy, pillowy, softer, we have softness there for you to see. Softest you can, softest you can see.
We put hundreds of little pillows in every sheet. It's two-ply softness you can see.
For any season. For any reason. Turkey fits your favorite taste. Enjoy turkey. It's your choice for today and tomorrow.
Apple Auto Glass, the pick of the crop.
Before it spreads and really costs you, get Apple's guaranteed stone chip windshield repairs. Just call
Apple Auto Glass,
the pick of the crop.
Now it's time for the TSN Turning Point, brought to you by National Trust. Linda?
Twice in one day, Randy Wojtowicz has to draw to the house in the extra end for the win. He throws it down the center of the ice where it's nice and keen, lets the sweepers take it. Really just dusting it. Perfect draw weight. It'll slide into the 8 foot and it'll be a win for Saskatchewan.
Randy Wojtowicz improves his record to 5-1. A cash donation will be made to the Coaching Association of Canada for the training and development of coaches in amateur sport on behalf of TSN and National Trust, helping you secure your future. We'll have more. We'll update the standings for you when we return to Cops Coliseum and the Labatt Briar. Okay, pass the converter. Now. Anybody want to watch Warren Beatty's new talk show?
Mm.
No.
Let's watch the Liberal Leadership Convention.
Now, that's exciting.
Hey, there's a mini-series about celebrities who go hiking.
Oh, I like nature.
Any television listing can tell you what's on, but only TV Guide tells you what's what. TV Guide, available at newsstands everywhere.
Celebrities who go hiking?
Yeah.
Mm. Isn't that the one where they take their kids along?
I think so.
Yeah, that's the one.
Hi.
Yes, hi.
We're here to talk to you about fiberglass pink insulation.
The insulation used by millions of Canadians.
If you insulate your house with fiberglass pink insulation,
you'll stay warm,
you'll save money,
and you'll get a free pink neon freestyle ski jacket.
Just like the one I'm wearing.
Buy 15 or more of these,
and get one of these.
The 1991 Labatt Briar is brought to you by Labatt's. Across Canada, beer at its best. We played six rounds, and here are the standings. Alberta, Saskatchewan keeping pace at 5-1. Newfoundland, Northern Ontario, 4-2. British Columbia, Ontario at 3-3. As well as Manitoba and the Territories. New Brunswick, PEI 2-4. Nova Scotia and Quebec are on the bottom at 1-5. The seventh round of this Labatt Briar will come your way at 1:30 p.m. Eastern Time, Wednesday afternoon, from here at Cops Coliseum in Hamilton. On behalf of Linda Moore, Ray Turnbull, and our entire crew, I'm Vic Rutter. Goodbye from the 1991 Labatt Briar in Hamilton.